फेलियर ऑफ रेल्स और हाउ रेल्स आर फेल्ड, व्हाट आर द डिफेक्ट्स ऑफ द रेल्स. सो द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्प्लिट्स, क्रैक्स और फिशर्स ऑन द रेल्स ड्यू टू डिफेक्ट ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चर, स्लिपिंग और स्किडिंग ऑफ व्हील इज नोन एज फेलियर ऑफ रेल्स और रेल फेलियर. सो हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ डिफेक्ट्स आर देयर, वी विल सी वन बाय वन. वन फिगर इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू जस्ट टू सी ऑल द टाइप ऑफ क्रैक्स और फेलियर्स. सो फर्स्ट इज टाइप्स ऑफ फेलियर्स, क्रश्ड हेड्स, स्क्वेयर और एंगुलर ब्रेक्स, स्प्लिट हेड्स, स्प्लिट वेब, हॉरिजॉन्टल फिशर, ट्रांसवर्स फिशर, फ्लोइंग ऑफ मेटल इन रेल हेड्स, हॉरिजॉन्टल क्रैक्स. वी विल ऑल सी दिस वन बाय वन एंड वी विल ऑल डिस्कस वन बाय वन. सो वेरी फर्स्ट इज क्रश्ड हेड्स. सो द रेल्स, रेल हेड्स विच गेट सैग्ड और फ्लैटेंड आर कॉल्ड क्रश हेड्स. सी इन दिस फिगर द रेल इज यूज्ड extensively, very much, or you can say the traffic over this rail is so much high that the rail head got crushed, right? So this is the example of a crushed head, right? See, it is not necessary that there must be the crack to get crushed. There must be flattened of rail also. See in this figure, in this crushes flow, the head is flattened from one side, got flattened from one side. Next is, see, this is also example of crushed head, that the top layer material gets chipped off by wear and tear. Next are square or angular breaks. When suppose there are two sleepers and there is no in between sleepers, from that rail get weakened, and after that when the train moves with a high speed or intensity, suddenly a jerk or you can say a crack appear in the rail. So after that it propagates after for so long years, and after suddenly one day it will split into two parts. So these type of crack are called square or angular breaks. The complete break of rail in a vertical plane is called square, or whereas in an inclined plane it is called angular breaks. If it is vertical, then it is square, and if it is inclined, these are called angular breaks. Next is, see, this is also example of square and angular breaks. Next, same, you will see. So next are split heads. So split heads means the head is totally flown over to another material and it gets splitted off longitudinally, right? The rail heads which gets cracked longitudinally in the middle are called split heads. If it is in longitudinal direction in along the length of the rail, then that splitting occurs, then it is called split heads. Next is split web. Same in longitudinal direction, when the rail web is cracked, these are the examples of split web. As you see, split webs are mostly occur where there are holes provided in the railway tracks. So that is why we must take care that the holes, the distance between the two holes should be that much particular distance or some significant distance, so that the crack would not propagate to that and it may have split webs in their section. See split web, wherever you see the split web defect, there must be a hole there. Most of the times, I should not say must word, I think there maximum of the time we can say. Next is a horizontal fissure, a horizontal crack along the length, but on the side of the rail, it is called horizontal fissure. See. Next is transverse fissure, the crosswise crack which start from a point inside the rail and develops like a contour shape gradually are called transverse fissure. See, this is the example of transverse fissure or crack. The crack which develops from inside, basically these are called transverse fissure. sea transverse fissures are also due to some, you know, oxide entrapment during the manufacture of this rail. There may be air trap, or you can say there may be mixing of some other metal. That's why these are the cracks due to, you can say these are the defects which are caused due to the chemical composition, or you can say the internal composition of the material. It is not by the weathering agencies. Basically, by weathering agencies, we have split webs, crushed heads, everything are by weathering agencies or by wear and tear of the rails. Next are horizontal cracks. See, it is just below the rail. That these type of rail failure occur at rail ends between the head and the web. At the junction where head and web meets, there that crack occurs. Next is pipe rails, in which, see, left portion is an animated word, it is a model, but actual is right side view, actual view, that the web is splitted up into two parts, and it is not fully splitted up to, only web is splitted, not head nor foot. So it makes a pipe over there. So that's why that's called piped rails. Next, slag pockets. Again, due to chemical composition. Next, porosity effect, water entrapment in the rail section. So these are some of the defects which are not, you know, given in your book. So these are the practical experiences we have taken. Next is flowing of metal in rail heads. Flowing of metal in rail means these type of rail failure occurs when the metal in the rail head is forced toward the sides and rail gets widened and depressed. So when we use, obviously we know that rail, the wheel of the train moves over rail side on one sided, there is the friction, and another side it is exposed to atmosphere. So again, by further many times when the rail get heated up and again the intensity of traffic is very much, then due to heating or due to say some another chemical composition, the metal becomes so soft that it get flowed into a direction. So see in next pic, you will see flow of metal in one direction. Every example is same. See flow of metal. Next topic is coning of wheels. So basically, rail wheels are not flat, as well as rails are not flat. These are provided at an inward slope of 1:20 are called coning of wheels. See, the rails are having a inward slope, right? And the rail is also at same level. From here you will see that how flow of metal occurs. Why flow of metal defect occurs in rails? Because rails, majority of the rails use only one side, or you can say half side of the rail basically. So that's why the flow of metal sometimes occurs, because the train is going to left to right, right to left. So that's why these are compensated by both sides. But if you will use only one, then flow of metal will definitely occur. It is not a big deal. See, this photo will give you clear view about the coning of wheel. You will see the wheels of the train are outwards, the slope are inwards, downward slope is inward, and upward slope is outwards, right? So this is complete axle picture. It is called two tires with a horizontal component in it. It is called axle. So this is the load which we consider during the design of railway track, right? See, this is coning of wheel. Again, I'm giving you with figures that you will have theory in many books. You can just go through any book, you will see all the theory portions, but my major motive is to show you how it looks like. looks like. Next is tilting of rails. So what is tilting of rails? Rails are obviously, as coning of wheels means, wheels are coned or sloped at an angle of 1:20, ratio of 1:20. And same, obviously, for the movement of the train, the rails are also tilted at a ratio of 1:20, then it is called tilting of rails. If it is the tilting of wheels, then it is called coning of wheels. And if it is tilting of rails, or you can say it, the slope is given to rails, then it is called tilting of rails. See, you will see there is a minor slope. It is not that much. It is just a minor slope. You will see. Some of the persons may, you know, signify that or can point out that, but many of with naked eye, it is somewhat difficult to see that it is inclined at an angle of slope of 1:20. See, next is edging of sleepers. Obviously, if you are going to tilt your rails, agar to see rails no tilt karna ek passe, right, then you must have to provide something beneath it so that it get tilted. Either you have to make the shape of the sleeper that way so that it if you put rail over it, it will get tilted to 1:20. So if the same slope is provided to sleeper, then it is called edging of sleeper or edging of sleeper, right? So I will tell you three main points here. If the slope of 1:20 is provided in wheels, train wheels, these are called coning of wheels. If it is provided in sleepers, then it is called edging of sleepers. If it is provided in rails, then it is called tilting of rails. Right? Next is chairs. Now, what are chairs? These are the fixtures and fastenings. Means the chairs are that fixtures or that fastenings which are required to fix the rail over the railway track, over the sleepers, are called chairs. All you have, I will mark you for here. So these are the chairs. These are the chairs. Right? Next, in position by chairs. See, you will see all the chairs here. These are the chairs. For the fixing of rails to the sleepers, it is called chairs. So thank you very much for this. So with this, we have completed our chapter Railways, including its defects and including coning of wheels, what is welding of rails, right? What are the different rail joints? What are the defects of the rails? So everything we have covered in rails chapter. So thank you so much. We'll start with next topic in our next video lecture. Thanks a lot.